Good evening, everyone. So this is my name is Priyanka Zundre, and I'm working in BNHS CEC as education officer. So we are glad to welcome you all in this very first online session on basic bird identification and bird watching. Before the session begins, I will introduce you to the BNHS and CEC. So BNHS, Bombay Natural History Society. We are pan-India. I hope everyone can listen to me, right? Can someone confirm? Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes, you are audible.
Thank you. So we are a pan-India organization. We are working in wildlife conservation and research from last 136 years. And CEC, basically CEC is Conservation Education Center, is the education wing of BNHS. Our center is in Goregaon East, inside Film City area, where we conduct educational activities like nature trail, online hybrid courses, eco birthday celebration for more than 20 years. I would like to introduce our today's speaker, Dr. Raju Kasambe. Raju sir, can we?
Yes.
He is assistant director in BNHS CEC Conservation Education Center. He's been with BNHS from last 10 years, and he has many. He is the author of many books like Important Bird Areas of Maharashtra, Threatened Birds of Maharashtra, Maharashtra Ki Fulpakre, Indian Grey Hornbill, and many more. So his area of interest is birds and butterflies. Apart from that, he is active on many websites like eBirds and I Found Butterflies. So yeah.
Okay.
Raju sir, thank you so much for joining. Over to you, Raju sir.
Hi everybody. Good evening. I hope everybody is safe at home, and we decided to start this series of online webinars for amateur naturalists and nature lovers from BNHS. So thank you, Priyanka. Priyanka is hosting this webinar today, and I welcome you all. So we have a center that is Punas Conservation Education Center in Mumbai, that is CEC. And just like YouTube, there is a small advertisement. We run online hybrid courses from CEC. Our first one is leadership course in biodiversity conservation. Then we have a basic course in ornithology. These courses are 11 months long. Then we have basic course in herpetology for 4 months, basic course in butterflies.
I guess there is a connection issue at the Raju sir's end. So I would like to continue this. So as I was saying, we have some courses, online hybrid courses. We conduct every year, that is leadership course, ornithology course, herpetology course, and butterfly course and botany. So in that, we actually...
Can you see a bird? Many people don't know that your birds, like the house sparrow, if you observe the house sparrows, what you observe is, I saw 10 house sparrows, 50 house sparrows. But what do they do? House sparrows take 3 types of bath every day. 3 types of bath. They take water bath, they take dust bath, they take sun bath. Beaters, green beaters. It's a common bird. They take 3 types of bath. Water bath, dust bath, sun bath. So it is so interesting. Many of us have never seen sparrows taking dust bath. You might have seen taking the water bath. Sorry, I was muted. Okay. Then you need to observe in detail, like what was the shape of the beak, for example. And the shape of the beak is very important in the classification of birds, in understanding the birds, in understanding what they eat. If you know what should be the shape of the bird, and you see the shape of the bird, you can easily tell what the bird is eating and should be eating. For example, these are granivorous birds. Look at the beak. All they have conical beak. It's like conical, and very strong with a broad, very broad base towards the face. You look conical beak. So that means they have very strong beak. So they are using to break something that is grains. So they eat grains. These are granivorous birds, sparrows, minions, bunting, rose finches. They eat grains, cereal crops, the grass seeds. Then there are birds which eat a lot of fruits, like the hornbills, parakeets, quails, and marbles. So they have seen, even in eating fruits, they have so many types of beaks. So the parakeet is expert in like digging out the pulp from a papaya or a custard apple, which a quail won't be able to do as expertly as the parakeet. The coppersmith and hornbill has to eat the fruit whole, just engulf or swallow the fruit whole. So that's the adaptation they have. And parakeet is the only bird which can hold a fruit in its feet and then think. Other birds can do it. Then the beak types. See, birds which feed on nectar. You might have seen a lot of documentaries about hummingbirds on National Geography. Everybody is familiar with hummingbirds, but nobody is familiar with our own hummingbird. That is the sunbird, which I have shown here one. So when somebody tells me this, that I saw a hummingbird in my garden, I'm so happy because that person who is not a non-birder has observed it so keenly that the bird feeds on nectar and hovers around the flower. That has to be complimented. So I tell him, yes, perfect. You said hummingbird. But only the thing is, hummingbirds are not found in India. That's a sunbird. They are very similar. No problem. You start observing, it's very good observation. So these are parallel. Yeah, it's an excellent example of convergent evolution. Then the flower picker and the oriental white eye. You look at the beak, especially made for getting nectar from the flowers. Look at the beak of these sunbirds, and you'll compare with hummingbirds, because that helps us in remembering. Then there are birds which feed on fish, like the cormorants. Cormorants catch fish. So if you give me a fish, even a dead fish, I cannot hold it in my hand. It just slips away, even if it is dead. But the cormorant can catch a live fish. It just chases the fish under the water and gets it. So it must have something special. So the beak is designed in such a way that the fish doesn't slip from its beak. So it has got serrations or teeth. So it catches the fish perfectly and the fish can't escape. So that's the adaptation. Then we have kingfishers. Beautiful kingfishers. You might be doing kingfisher. Kingfisher, we have mineral water and we have other brands also people are more interested in nowadays. They are not getting because of lockdown. That kingfisher. Okay. So the kingfisher is an expert in diving and getting the fish which is swimming underwater. Here is a sequence of photographs showing how the common kingfisher gets the fish. And there is another bird like a river turtle. Like a river turtle, which also dives, yeah, but shallow. It's a shallow dive. It's a shallow diving and gets fish. So, and there are woodpeckers, which are experts. The beak is strongest in woodpeckers. And they can even drill through the trunk of a tree or a wood. And that's this type of beak is known as chisel. Then we have raptors, are the birds of prey. That means they eat flesh. So they must have beak which is powerful and hooked and can tear the flesh. So we have raptors. And raptors are like hawks, falcons, sikra, kestrels. These are all raptors. And among the raptors, we have some birds like the owls, which are nocturnal raptors, but they have this similar beak. So they feed in the night. And then among the raptors, we have vultures, which feed on the day, but also they need to tear the flesh. So they are also raptors. Then we have birds which are which feed by probing into the mud, like this spoon beam, ideas, curly sandpiper. So look at the type of beaks. Even for probing mud, they have so many types of beaks. And this is a beautiful illustration I found on the internet. See, look at the length of the waders. Waders means long-legged birds which feed in mud. So look at the length of their beak. So how they can go to the depth in the mud and reach out to the various types of animals hiding in the mud. So this is how the differentiation and adaptation in beaks helps them in feeding on various types of food. Then there are crows and tree pies. These are generalist feeders. Generalist means omnivores. They can feed on anything, like they carry on roti, water, even on flesh, everything. And there are one more expert, that is flamingos. Flamingos feed only on microalgae in water. So, and they're being specially designed. You can see here, that's known as filter feeding or seal feeding. And then we have flycatchers. Flycatchers are the big, looks like, it looks like tiny, but when it opens, it is big. That's known as gape. So the gape is big. So when they are trying to catch an insect, the gape needs to be bigger. And of course, we have frog mouth. Frog mouth, you look at the big, it looks like small, but when it opens like big jaw. So that is the trick, because it has to fly, it has to catch insects and they fly in the night when they can't really see. And that's why the big, when it opens, or the gap is bigger than actually you feel it is. And cattle egrets are also insectivorous birds. Then we have the various types of feet. Look at the feet. These are webbed feet, like the ducks or river terns and flamingos, and even common coop. These are the birds which need to walk in the mud as well as they need to swim. So both purposes, they can use this. Then we have birds known as perching birds, or the passerines. These are the commonest birds which are around us, like the sparrows and crows. So these are birds, these have a special mechanism. As soon as the branch touches, so the toes close. So when they are sleeping, even the bird is dead and you touch here, the toes close automatically. These birds are known as perching birds. Crows, babblers, pigeons, bulbuls, all these common birds are the birds which use perching mechanism, and they are known as passerines. Then we have some birds which have a very long toes, and those are specially adapted so that they can walk on aquatic vegetation. So the one of them is the jacana, bronzing jacana, and pheasant jacana, then water wrens, moor wrens, swamp wrens. These are the birds which have a very long toes, and they can walk on floating vegetation, like lotus or water lilies. They can easily walk. Then we have special talons of raptors. So raptor means birds of prey, and they have very powerful talons, means nails, and they can catch anything they can manage. Like owls are experts in catching rats and mice in the night. Osprey is expert in catching fish. Just imagine catching fish with its feet, and the fish is in the water. So still it can catch, and the fish won't sleep. So that's the mechanism of the talons, such a powerful talon. Then there are all the raptors which we mentioned are about the hooked beak. They are the birds of prey, and they have such powerful talons, like the eagles, falcons, hawks, kestrels, shikra, and kites and owls. Then we have birds like the herons and egrets, which walk in mud. So they have a little bit of longer toes, but they do. They also perch in trees. They also walk in mud. And we have birds like woodpeckers. They need to climb trees. They walk vertically. So what they have? Two toes up, two toes down. So four toes are divided like that. And they can easily climb on the tree trunk. That's the adaptation only woodpeckers and nuthatches have. Okay, that's about the types of feet. Then bird watching is not only about watching. Sometimes people say watching is through the eyes, but bird watching is also means it's through the ears. So you might be knowing Tansen, who was a very, very good singer, and people still Tansen is the best. So you need to be Tansen to understand birds, to listen to the birds. Birds are always calling. Early morning, 5 o'clock, birds start calling around our house, and if you are a Tansen, you can hear them. You can identify what bird it is. So use your ears for bird watching. And now listen to this bird.